Ted Hill, and may we want to receive Mary as it come around. And I would just say, let God have his way.
Amen.
You're not in no hurry. I don't believe in putting a time frame on the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
You can't put a time frame on the Holy Ghost anyway. So let God have him. I thank God for the man of God. He's truly a prophet. Amen.
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 See, I can speak it because I call it like I see it. Yeah, he's a true prophet.
Yes, he is.
He's truly a prophet, truly anointed. Amen. So we want to just sit back and buckle up and go for the ride. Amen.
Amen.
We want to go along for the ride. A lot of people want to sit in the back. I want to sit in the front.
Amen. Come on.
Well, I can see. But we thank God for him today. Amen. Let's thank God for feeding you. Prepare to receive the man of God coming in the pastorship. Who's excited about being in the house of the Lord?
Yeah.
Come on, don't fool me now.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise is not what I do. Praise is who I am. Now, Mr. Sheldon, on. And we say when praises come up, blessings come down.
That's right.
But that ain't Bible, y'all. The Bible says he inhabits the praises of his people.
That's right.
So when we lift him up,
come on.
Back in time, he comes down. And if you got the blesser, you can have the blessing. Come down to the side. Let me tell you one thing. When we lift him up, the blessings don't come down. The blesser come down. Y'all ain't talking back to me. Everybody wants the blessing to come down. If you got the main one, hallelujah, you can have the blessing. Y'all still ain't praising them right there. Everybody wants the blessing to come down and suck with you. Come on, somebody. We want the hand of God, but we don't want the heart of God. Sister Sheffield got my last name. So she got my heart, she got my hand. Y'all ain't talking back to me. If you get the heart of God, y'all still missing the shout of God. You can get the hand of God. Y'all ain't saying nothing back to me. Well, how do I get in trust, preacher? Praise him. Y'all ain't talking back to me. How do I get in trust, preacher? In spiritual warfare, there were cherubims, there were seraphims, and there was Lucifer.
Right.
Lucifer was over the choir.
Right.
He's in a fallen state.
That's right.
When he said in Genesis 1 and 26, let us make man, he was looking for somebody to replace Lucifer to worship him. God is in fact. Don't you understand that you were created to worship God? And I'm feeling you lift him up. And every time you lift your hand, and you just took him away, y'all can't let you out of here. If there ain't anybody, brother, let the devil know that every power is not his. If there ain't anybody, he used to be, and I took him away.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, I feel the blessing. See, we don't need to be in the airport, we don't need to be in the airport, but we need to go in the holders of holders. Come on, where no flesh, no bread in his presence. Well, I can take back everything. feel a blessing in this place. If he show up, I can have a blessing. I ain't worried about them. I just need God to show up in this place. If God show up, come on, my high blood pressure can come down. If God show up, and that sickness got to leave my body. If God show up, come on, the devil got to flee. If God show up, everything that's not like God got to get up out of the atmosphere. If there anybody want God to show up, to be praised. Woo! I said he's worthy.
Yes, it is.
Woo! To be praised.
To be praised.
He's worthy.
Worthy, 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 worthy.
To be
worthy. Worthy to be praised. Worthy.
He's worthy.
He's worthy.
To be praised.
To be praised.
Come on, y'all, still quiet. He's worthy.
He's worthy.
To be praised. The Bible says when Israel was down in bondage, the Bible says apostles that they cried. Woo! They made a loud noise.
Yeah.
When they were in bondage in Egypt, the Bible said they opened their mouth, prophets, and they made a loud noise.
Yeah.
And God began to summon Moses, and now they saying nothing. See, when you open your mouth, what you can't see will be on the way. Y'all missing the sound of it. When you begin to cry out and say, God, help me. He's keeping.
Yeah.
Thank God, he's keeping. I stood up, man of God, and I said, now that's a blessing that he's keeping.
Yeah.
But I thank God that he kept.
He kept. Yeah.
And listen to mama, and listen to Charlotte mama right there. See, I thank him that he's keeping me right now.
But
what
kept.
I really praise him for is that he kept me. Hallelujah, he is worthy of all my praise. We had 10,000 tongues. We could not praise Him enough.
Right.
His grace and His mercy. And hallelujah. Come on, give yourselves a hand clap.
Amen.
Come on, give your apostle, the man of God, a hand of praise. Come on.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. The man of God, Apostle Anderson.
Amen.
Sister Dad, Divine Direction Church. Come on, give yourself a hand of praise. God, we accept it. Church home, hallelujah. I'm an honorary member. Y'all ain't got to go to me. I'm going to stay out.
That's right. That's true.
Just because it got church in front of it, the name on the building, does not mean God is there.
That's true.
I ain't saying nothing.
Say it, something.
Amen. Y'all can say it. But we thank God for the apostolic voice.
That's right.
Yes.
His place. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 12:28, He placed first in the church.
Come on.
Apostles.
That's right.
Secondarily, prophets. Y'all ain't talking about me.
That's right.
He gave some, Ephesians 4:11, apostles.
Yeah.
He gave some prophets.
Whoa.
So which means everybody that you don't have what you have.
Come on.
That's true.
Talking back to
that's me. True. Come on.
We want to thank God.
That's true.
That you have apostolic covering.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Somebody that can watch over your soul.
Yes, Lord.
And intercede for you. Hallelujah. And the enemy want to take you out, you're going to thank God for apostolic.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Those of you that have the Bibles, I promise you, Apostle said we're not in time, but I heard somebody cooked. Now I know how I am. I'm food. I pray for me. Yeah, it's gonna be 20 minutes. We're gonna eat. Hallelujah. I promise you, I'm Baptist. I'm trying to tell y'all, I'm Baptist. And we be out at 11:15, so I ain't got long. 12:43. Told y'all I'm Baptist. I grew up in a Baptist church. 1:15, we out every Sunday. Football game coming on in a few minutes. Revelations, the 12th chapter. Revelations.
Wow.
Those who can, please stand to your feet quickly. Revelations, the 12th chapter. I believe this is a rhema word, a prophetic utterance.
My God.
God had apostles on assignment. Growing up in Michigan Baptist Church, you have teaching engagements. When you operate in the apostolic, prophetic, master, teacher, evangelist, amen, I believe God places assignments on apostles and prophets.
Yes.
And He has a designated word for a designated people.
Amen. That's true.
Which means everybody that's here today, amen, was destined to hear this word
that's right.
God is giving all of us collectively.
That's right.
Corporately, prophetically.
Thank you, Father God.
I believe it's a rhema word from the Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus. I told my big sister over there, Richard, I said, I didn't sleep none last night.
Wow.
And the most multiplicity of words coming through my mind, but I said, God is going to give me what to speak when I get there.
Yes, He will.
Amen. But we thank the Lord for His word. Revelations, the 12th chapter. Revelations, the 12th chapter. And we're going to start. I'll be reading until the 12th verse. I don't want to read too much.
Thank you, Lord.
Let's start in verse 5. I'll read you 7 verses.
Thank you, Lord.
You understand this is the 8th month, 2nd Sunday.
Yes.
It says a new beginning and 2 is the number of covenant. Shout new beginning.
New beginning!
When you see God speak more than once, in scripture, He'll say truly, truly, or verily, verily. That means it's settled.
Wow.
Mr. Shouting.
Wow.
That means it's a done deal.
Woo!
That I'm talking about.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
That means it's concrete.
Yeah.
Y'all Y'all can say that one.
Come on.
So no, not only is this a new beginning for you guys.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
God has cut covenant.
Woo!
Anybody know anything about being God in a God of covenant? And then, listen, you can take care loose of his hand, but he won't take loose of your hand.
That's right. Come on.
When God put covenant in with an individual, it's hard to get around the will of God.
Come on.
When he had told you something.
Right.
He said his word, mama, cannot return to the void.
That's right.
Whatever he sent it out to accomplish, it's going to do just that. You can't do nothing to get around the will of God when he told you he had cut covenant.
Come on, that's right.
Revelations, the 12th chapter. Watch this. And I think we can shout and go home after I just read the scripture. Y'all gonna catch it. We can go home and
eat.
Starting in verse 5. The Bible says, she bore a male child who was the ruler over nations with a rod of iron. And a child was caught up to God and his throne. Then the woman fled into the wilderness. Listen, where she has a place prepared by God.
Right.
That they should feed her, listen, there 1,260 days.
Wow.
And a war broke out. Shout war.
War!
A war broke out in heavens. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon.
Well.
And the dragon and his angels fought. But they did not prevail.
That's
let me
right.
Read that again.
Come on.
But they did not prevail.
That's right.
Nor was a place found for them in heaven any longer.
Any longer.
That was a shout moment right there.
Woo!
So the great dragon was cast out.
That's right.
The serpent of old called the devil and Satan, who deceives the whole world. He was cast to the earth, and his angels was cast out with him. Watch this, verse 10. Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of this Christ has come. And the accuser of the brethren who accused them before God day and night has been cast down. Now, some of y'all are going through what you're going through. Now, they're talking back to me. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. And they did not love their own lives to death. Verse 12 is the kicker. Therefore rejoice. Shout rejoice.
Rejoice!
O heavens, and you will dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and the sea. For the devil has come down to you, having great wrath, because he knows that his time
is
short. Look at neighbor and I and say,
neighbor,
it's over with.
It's over with.
See, some of y'all ain't shopping right there.
It's over with.
Neighbor, the Lord just told you.
The Lord told you.
That it's over with.
It is over with.
Y'all say it back to me.
Woo!
I can't get no help with this Catholic church. Woo! My dad even high-fived your neighbor and say, neighbor, all the hell you been going through, it's over with. All the tears you been shedding, y'all ain't say that back to me. It's over with. understand demonology 101, according to Isaiah, the 14th chapter, around verse 12, the Bible says, you can be seated if you can, the Bible declares, and he talks about, amen, O Lucifer, the fallen angel. The Bible declares, he said, he lift his, amen, heart above the heart of God. And the Bible says in Isaiah the 14th chapter, verse 12, watch this now, that old Lucifer has fallen.
That's it.
That's the first key I want to make, that Lucifer, the son of the morning, has fallen. Now, I don't know about y'all, but I never read when the devil got up.
That's right.
Number two, he always gonna fight the word of God.
That's right. Come on, praise God.
The enemy will have you in a place where you can't receive the word of God.
My God, my God.
Because faith comes by hearing.
And hearing.
And hearing.
By the word of God.
Come on, come on. And how can you hear, preach for without a preacher?
Come on.
How can he preach, preach for except he be sick? The first thing going to speak to
is your
spirit. Shout out the spirit. So you must understand that before God gets ready to move, watch this now, the war always takes place.
That's right. Come on.
I'm going to feel like running right here.
That's right.
I said, I'm going to feel like running right here. I said, the first thing, woo, when God gets ready to move, my, a war always takes place.
Come on.
Because the Bible said the earth was not formed and void, and darkness crept upon the face of the earth, and then the Spirit of God began to move. Y'all missed the shouting moment. The Bible said in Matthew the 4th chapter, he said, why don't you, amen, bow down and worship me, and I give you the kingdoms of this world.
Yeah.
Jesus looked at the devil and said, please don't miss it. And he said, but this man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. He said, proceeded out of the mouth of God. Which God always speak, amen, in spirit. But why, amen, watch this now. Why should Jesus bow down to something that was already his?
That's right.
Come back to me. I said, that the first thing, the move of God took place, the devil always gonna show his head. This was right before Jesus got there to do his earthly ministry, and here come the war. Here come the warfare. Look your neighbor in the eye and say warfare.
Warfare.
You are in warfare right now. And I came to tell you, you got some help, y'all. You got some Michaels, y'all. To let you know, hallelujah, that God is getting ready to move for you. So instead of you having a pity party, you need to have a praise party. You need to celebrate. Because God is getting ready to move for you. Because God is getting ready to move for me. God is getting ready to bless me.
That's right. That's right. Come on. That's true.
Warfare.
Woo!
All that's going to show up.
Come on now, preacher.
Before the blessing comes. So watch this now. There is purpose in your pain.
That's right. Come on. Say that again. Say it again.
I'm going to get ready to run down place with my promise on him. I said there is purpose. Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Come on.
In your pain. Y'all ain't talking back to me. A lot of us want to pray the pain away.
That's right.
Talking back to me. A lot of us want God to pull us up out of the situation we're in.
Come on.
Back to me.
Come
but
on.
I just read some more Bible. I just love the Bible. Y'all got to excuse me. There was Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And the Bible said they wouldn't bow down to the King of Jesus. They wouldn't worship a dance to the but the Bible declares that they threw them in.
That's right.
They threw them in, Bible. Hallelujah. And now but the flame got higher. Some of y'all are in some hot situations. By the fact that it got hotter and hotter, y'all. And hotter and hotter. Y'all ain't saying nothing. It's hot right now. Y'all ain't saying nothing. But you have to understand this flame that you in right now is not to make you bitter. It's to make you better. Y'all ain't talking back to me. This fire I'm in now is to make the better. Was even prophesied about in the book of Daniel. The Bible says that the king acknowledged and said, don't that look like the Son of God? Y'all been talking shit.
Come on.
Hey, come on. See, I told him I used to pray on work. P-R-E-Y. It's the P-R-E-Y. My enemies away.
Come on.
Mama, I had to learn to pray for him. Because I read some more Bible. Y'all excuse me, I love Bible. I told you about it. In Sunday school. And I met my man, read a scripture that said, he's prepared a table.
Table.
You went to Sunday school. He prepared a table before them and the presence of all our enemies. Y'all ain't talking back to me. In this season, we get ready to go in. You don't need folks that's going to tolerate you. You don't need folks that's going to celebrate you. So God don't have my enemies right there. So when he spreads the table, we don't need to acknowledge you. Y'all ain't shout with me up there.
That's right. Come on, that's true.
Hey. Can I show it to you in the scripture?
Yeah.
I told my pastors I'd love to give you the scripture when I make a point. You got to understand that Acts 16 chapter, the Bible class, that Paul and Silas are walking amongst the street. The Bible said there was a young lady that was full of revelation. That word revelation in the Greek means Pisces. It means pipe cover. It means it squeezes the life out of you. Some of y'all been in some situations that's trying to squeeze the life out of you.
Come on.
But you must understand, the Bible said Paul's spirit got vexed. The reason some of y'all ain't getting vexed is not because, please, Pastor Sheffield, it's not because, amen, you're down and out. The Bible said the man of God's spirit got vexed, and he didn't speak to the girl, he spoke to the spirit. When your spirit gets vexed, some of y'all need to start talking to some stuff. Y'all ain't talking back to me. I told you, your wrestle ain't with people. It ain't the boss man on the job. It's that demon you're wrestling. It's that prince of Persia. Against flesh and blood, it's spiritual wickedness, it's principalities, and high places. Y'all ain't talking back to me, but you must understand. Oh, I feel like preaching. One can chase 1,000, and two can chase 10,000. Don't you know you got enough Holy Ghost in you that in your wicked corner, you're stronger than the devil? Put your name in the house and say, neighbor, I've got enough power in me to cast out demons.
That's right. Come on. Say it again.
Look at that and say, David, this is spiritual.
It's a spiritual.
So, let me get it out. Can I show it to you?
Come on.
Look at that and say, neighbor, I got to worship.
Neighbor, I got to worship.
Look at that and say, neighbor, I got to worship.
Neighbor, I got to worship.
Look at that and say, neighbor, I need some word.
Neighbor, I need some word.
Mr. Neighbor, you're going to go through warfare. You're going to go through warfare, but here it is. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you ain't got to fight.
You ain't got to fight.
See, the advantage of the believer is going into a fixed fight.
Come on.
That's already won.
Yeah, it is.
Woo! And this is your moment right there. Because we think we got to fight like this. Now they're talking back to me. The only fight that God told us to fight was the good fight of faith. Can I go get Peter? I'm going to give you some more Bible. Peter, the enemy desired to sit you as weed. But he said, I prayed for you that your faith faileth you not. Sometimes, Tiffany, we don't know how to pray. Sometimes our mind can be so messed up. You don't know how to call on the name of the Lord. Can I get down some more Bible? I told you I love the Bible. The Bible says in Romans 8 chapter, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. And moanings and groanings that cannot be uttered. Sometimes when you can't pray in English, some work. Number three, worship in the word Macintosh will bring warfare.
That's right, come on.
All right.
Say it.
But in the midst of the warfare,
well,
I told you, you don't have to fight.
That's right.
Come on. This battle don't belong to you.
That's right. Battle's the Lord.
It belongs to the Lord.
To the Lord.
My wife taught me this because me being an intercessor and me being a demon chasing, demons don't chase me, I chase them.
Come on.
Because if you put on the whole armor of God, watch this now, Revelation, the armor is not meant for the backside of a soldier.
Amen. All right, come on. Come on.
Let me say it again. Y'all been shouting on me. The armor is not meant for the backside.
That's right. It's for the front.
Now, the Bible says this. I mean, you throw the
whole armor of God. Blade of righteousness. Helmet of salvation.
You have the shield of faith. You have the sword, which is the word of God. So when the fire of God comes, the Bible said, did not say that it wasn't going to come. They said they will not prosper.
That's right. Come on.
But you got to understand, the devil is aiming at a moving target.
Now, I'm
talking back to me. See, when you say you're going through, that's exactly what it means. I'm going through. Y'all ain't saying nothing back to me.
Woo!
Which means I'm not going to stay
right
here where I'm at. Y'all don't have to be sharp. I'm not going to always be broke. I'm not going to always be on EBT. I'm not going to always be catching the bus to church. I'm not going to always be making minimum wage. I'm not going to always be low and y'all going to shop. The more they begin to get strong.
Come on!
Talking back to me. So you got to understand that the devil was there in the beginning. And so since he was there in the beginning, he knows the untapped potential that God placed on the inside
on
of you. And the reason he don't want you to come around apostles, prophets, evangelists, and teachers, because the Bible said to me, I will come into the unity of the faith, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry. Don't miss it. That's not the shouting moment. That we will be no longer tossed to and fro by every wind and doctrine. So what the apostles and the prophets do, they establish you. They make your plant, your feet planted in God. They make you grow up and stop getting off the nipple. What the apostles do, they grow you up. So when you look at a demon, you can say, I've seen him before, and I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. When you see a demon trying to attack your child, instead of you talking about generational curses, you say that curse is broken in the name of Jesus. And I'm not going to pass down a generational curse. I'm going to pass down a generational blessing. Look your neighbor in the eye and say, neighbor, I feel myself getting a little strength up in here. Because now I'm back in a place where God.
Yes.
It was going to rule over the nation.
Yes, yes, Lord.
You realize that David, you're carrying something.
David, you're carrying something.
And the enemy is after your birthright.
Come on.
The devil is after your seed.
Come on.
The enemy is after what God placed on the inside of you. And apostle, I feel in this place there's some gifts. Don't be unlocked. Because the devil told Jesus, if you are the Son of God, Jesus already knew who he was. But by the time we leave this place today, every blessed by believer, who they are, everybody that's weak, go be strong. Everybody that's poor, go be rich. You got to know who you are in God. Carrying a missus, a child, that fool got me now. He's carrying a child. Then a woman fled in the wilderness. I said, now, told you, you're going to go, amen, in warfare. But sometimes, Nicky Nelson, God will place you in the wilderness. Now, it sounds crazy, and it's messed up.
Come on.
Because how you going to place me in the wilderness?
Come on.
But sometimes God's Spirit will send you into some strange places.
That's, yeah, he will.
Yeah,
it will. Come on, preacher.
If your neighbor lies, your neighbor in the wilderness.
I'm in the wilderness.
But sometimes, don't listen to the shopping moment. Sometimes no isolation will bring revelation.
Come on now, yes it will.
Y'all miss me. Y'all miss me. They don't believe me, but I saw through in the scripture. The Bible said Exodus, I'm giving you. The Bible said Exodus, the Moses took the Hebrew slave. So he began to run, amen. And when he began to run, he ran into the desert.
Moses. Come on.
The Bible says the Spirit of God, watch this now, the Spirit of God led Jesus to the wilderness to be tempted of the devil.
That's right. Come on.
The Bible says Isaac, just like Abraham was in a family. The Bible says the Spirit of God, in Genesis the 25th chapter, he told Isaac, here he is, to go to a desolate place, to go to a famine. And when you go to a famine, I want you to go to the famine. Watch this now. And he told him, I want you to plant a seed. And the Bible said in Genesis 25th chapter, that the famine that Isaac was in was worse than Abraham.
Wow.
The Bible said, amen, when Paul got off the street called Frey, the Bible said, God told him, don't go consult with flesh and blood, but go to Arabia for 14 years, and I'm going to give you a revelation. I'm going to give you some instructions. The Bible said, Abraham, get from among your kindred. I need you to leave and go to a place that I'm going to show you. Sometimes the Spirit of God will lead you to some wilderness places. You don't look like God is moving, but I can't just help somebody. God working behind the scenes.
Yes,
I say, God working behind the scenes. And my mama told me, when you can't trace God, you got to trust God. Look your neighbor in the eye and say, neighbor, when you don't know that he's working. When you don't know that he's moving, preacher, he's moving. When you don't know that he's making a way out of no way, he's making a way out of no way. But you got to stand in faith. When it don't look like God is working, he that keepeth Israel don't sleep, nor does he slumber.
Come on! Neighbor, I'm in the wilderness.
But Mr. Shawty's over right there in the text. Because Tiffany, the wilderness was prepared by God.
Come on, yes it was.
Yeah, they said this back to me. I can go home right there. I said the wilderness was prepared by God. Your place of safety was prepared by God. Your isolation was your revelation. That you might get application, that manifestation. Your revelation,
come on.
That you might have application, that you might have manifestation.
Come on now.
Say it again. Your isolation, it's your revelation, that you might have application.
Yes, sir.
Apply it, that it might manifest. second.
Come on.
I'm getting ready to do something this season.
Come on.
It's Matthew fast. You should worry about tomorrow.
That's right.
That's good.
What you gonna wear?
That's right. Come on.
Yeah, I'm telling somebody right here. Yeah. What you gonna eat?
Come on. That's true.
I'm writing a book right now called Authentic Faith.
That's good.
It's easy to have faith when you can work on hours and you know you got a check.
Come on. That's true. Say
another
that.
Thing to have faith when you don't know.
Say that now. Say that now. Come on, preacher.
Coming back to me. God says she was in the wilderness. She was in a place prepared by God. Go visit. Where he fed.
Yes, he did.
I'm talking about y'all. He said, from 1,260 days.
Yeah, he gonna feed us.
Come on. In other words, what you've been wrestling and fighting for It's already done.
Come on, yes it is.
Y'all missing the shot moment. Y'all missed the shot moment right there.
Hey!
That Michael and the angels were fighting before you got your blessing.
Come on, there they were.
Y'all ain't talking back to me. Listen, look your neighbor and ask your neighbor to fight already been born. What you been crying about? You might as well dry your tears up, baby. You get ready to do an exchange. You get ready to claim beauty for ashes. Y'all ain't saying nothing. What you been worried about? I already been taken care of. What you been laying up for a while? Look your neighbor and ask your neighbor. In this season that you in, I need you to lift your head up, poke your chest out, and walk like it's already done. Now the song we sung, baby, you just got to walk it out. And I walk by faith. Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Come on.
You understand that back to me. Can I come in just a little bit?
Come on, Paul.
The second chapter said, you got to know the things that's freely given to you. He said, I've given you great and precious promises. So you won't escape the world of corruption through love that you might take on. It is the very nature of God. Now, talking back to me. So God don't desire to save you and don't desire to heal you.
That's right.
God don't desire to save you and don't desire to give you money.
Come on.
God don't desire to save you and not give you the house that you want. God don't desire to save you and not give you the husband and the wife that you really need. God just don't desire to save you because so salvation means nothing missing and nothing broken. Look your neighbor in the eye and say, neighbor, hope the duck that sat on the wall. Hope the duck that had a great father. All the king horses and all the king men could not put them up the duck back together again. But I know a king.
Who can?
Y'all missing. I said, I know a king that's able to put some stuff back together again. And everything that's broken and everything that's missing in your life, God just told me to prophesy that's getting ready to come back together. All the broken pieces that's getting ready to come back together. All the missing branches that's getting ready to connect again. Because salvation means nothing missing.
Nothing.
Broken.
That's right.
Says, and he said before God, day and night, accusing the brother. Now, this is my teaching. Because I believe everybody ain't the money to possess, but you can be satanically influenced.
Mm. Come on, say it.
I got some more scriptures to give. do. By Paul the Glass, he says, in Romans 6 chapter, he said, I found something in my members that go against the law of God. He said, I found evil in me. Every time I desire to do good, evil is always present. He was not talking about individual people. He was talking about his flesh. Yeah. Got to back to me.
Come on.
God Glass, when Jesus asked the disciples, who do men say that I am? Huh? And they said, some say you lie, some say you're the prophet. And then Peter says, some say, amen. I mean, I believe that you are the Son of God. If you read the next scripture, he told Peter, get down behind me, Satan. Now, Peter was not, amen, the demonically possessed, but he was satanically influenced.
Right, right.
You must understand that the devil always gonna throw accusations.
That's right. Come on, come on.
People of God, y'all ain't talking back to me.
That's
the devil always gonna throw accusations. Y'all ain't saying them back
That's
to me.
Right, come
he
on.
Don't miss the shouting moment. Not the world, but the brother.
Come on now.
Talking back to me. That's his job to accuse. That's his job to put out lies.
Come on.
Can I give you demonology 101? Y'all ain't saying nothing back to me. What thing about the demonic forces? Only thing they can do is make noises.
Come on.
Now, the devil can't come as a roaring. The Bible says he can't come like a lion. He come as a roaring lion. Once a lion gets old, watch this, mama, his teeth fall out, and the only thing he got is a loud
noise. Come on.
And ain't talking back to me. The devil ain't doing nothing but keeping up noise. I can't get no help in this Catholic church. And the Bible says they overcame them.
Yeah, by the blood of the Lamb.
Don't listen. And the word of my testimony. When you, when the devil starts making noises, you got to start making noise.
Come on.
I'm getting ready to go home now. I'm taking down too much. I said, when the devil makes noise,
yeah,
you got to make noise. Because what you oppose, what you come up against, supposed to come up against you. But the difference between you and it, you already won. Lift your name, put your eyes down. I'm going to need you to start making some noise in this season.
Come on. That's right.
But if you chose it for it,
woo,
you're going to overcome it.
Yes, you will.
Sometimes chaos got a way of showing you
wow,
the Christ is really in you.
My God, my God.
Mr. Shalimov.
Yeah, Lord.
I got some more about it. The Bible says if the devil had known, he would have placed Jesus on the tree.
Mm.
Wow. That's it right there. Yeah. If the devil had known and met with you, that you'll be praying like you pray.
My God, my God.
The devil had known that you'll be fasting like you fast.
Woo!
Devil had known to mess with you because sometimes the anointing has
wow,
to be crushed.
Wow.
You don't know you really anointed until you're in a dry place and can bring light to a dry place.
Yeah, Lord.
You don't know you really anointed until you're in a dry place and can tap a rock and water come out.
Mm, come on now.
You don't really know you're anointed until you're in a trial.
Wow, come on now. That's true.
That's it.
Say it.
My servant, Jehovah. Job came out last scripture. Getting ready to do something the devil ain't gonna do. That's lead out along. That's just Bible says verse 11, Job came out of the Southern Word of Testimony. And he did not love and lie to the devil. Mm. Verse 12 is the kicker. He says, after all this, rejoice.
Rejoice.
Ye heavens.
Ye heavens.
Rejoice. He said, after all this, O heavens, rejoice, and you who dwell in them, walk to the habitations of the earth and the sea. For the devil Now come down with great wrath.
That's right.
Because he knows.
He know. His time is short.
His time.
Woo!
Is short.
That's right. Yes, it is.
I believe I can close the book on that note.
Come on.
He know.
He know.
That his time.
That's right.
Is up in your life.
Come on now. Come on.
He know.
Yes, it is.
He know. I told you, he know your destiny. He's not fighting where you at.
He's fighting where you're going.
Woo! That's a shouting moment. I'm getting ready to go now.
Come on.
He's not concerned about where you at. He's concerned about where you're getting ready to go.
Come on.
And I need everybody to y'all see me. I need about two people that know that you know that you know that you getting ready to go somewhere.
Yeah!
He already know that his time is up. It's an expiration date on your tribulation.
Come on now.
These light afflictions are but for a moment, but they work in more minds a great and exceeding glory. The suffering of this present age is not worthy to be compared according to the glory that shall be revealed after this right here. I'm looking at your glory, but I don't know your story. Y'all ain't talking back to me. And after you come out of this, God is going to get some glory.
Yes, it is.
Y'all missed the shout of the I said, after you come out of this, God is going to get some glory.
Come on!
After you come through this,
woo!
God will bless us in your life. After you come through this,
that's right. Come on, preacher.
Watch this. Come on, y'all. This here. Watch this. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Watch this. Watch this. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. For the word. Watch this. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Lift your hands in this place. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
Cry out to you, Father.
Lift your hands.
Oh, we cry to you, Jesus.
Yes.
Yes.
Come on, let's worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, let's see. Come on. Magnify him. Hallelujah. Come on. Shut up.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you that it's over.
Yes.
Thank you. Come on, worship him. That's it. Come on, worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Watch his worship.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus.
This is a prophetic moment. Come on.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
This is a Hallelujah. Come on, let's say, come on, Zach.
My Lord, my Lord.
He calls men to rise over your head.
Come on now.
We went through the fire and through the wall.
Wow.
But he brought us out.
Yeah, he did.
In a wealthy place.
Woo! Well, good place.
He calls men to rise over my head. I went through the fire and went through the wall.
Yeah, Lord.
But he brought me out.
Woo! Went through it all.
In a wealthy place.
Woo!
Yeah, I believe your promise is here now. And the devil tried to open your life. And that Egyptian you've been fighting, you ain't got to fight no more.
Come on.
I prophesy now. I said the demon you've been fighting, you ain't got to fight no more.
Come on now.
I prophesy to the whole church. I said what you've been wrestling with. And put it in my wallet.
Wow.
I was so distraught by the enemy taking my identification, gas card, my twin card, all my certifications. The enemy took everything.
Mm.
A red card. I'm unidentified individual.
Come on now.
Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Come on.
But you got to understand. You got to know your identity in Christ.
That's right. Come on. Yeah, we do.
Y'all missing the shot.
Woo!
Y'all coming back to me. You got to know who you are.
I know who I am.
See, it ain't your name. He said he'll make your name great. But it ain't your name you going in.
Mm.
Y'all ain't talking back
child
to
of God.
It's what his name says.
That's right.
Y'all ain't talking back to the preacher. Lift your hands over God. I'm telling you. That's it. Now, in a situation somebody is going to come out. And right now, you're going to look like what you're going through. Mm. Lift your hands.
Come on.
When I seen three angels. Woo. See Michael fighting for you. Mm. I seen goodness on this side.
My God. My God.
And mercy on this side. Can I say that back to you? The Bible says that wealth and riches shall be in our house. Hallelujah. Mm. The Bible says you shall flourish.
Yes, Lord.
In the house of God. You don't look like what you've been through. But I'm telling you, in this hour, there are some miracles that's going to hit your house.
My God.
In less than 24 hours. Woo! You are desperate.
Hello.
It's almost like it's an emergency.
Come on, come on.
But I tell you to holler back with your Lord and say, help is on the way.
Help is on the
way. Now, y'all understand this? I tell you to holler, help is on the way. And there's mercy on this side.
Come on.
And because you're in a place, hallelujah, you just surrender. Say, God, I don't know, but I'm going to give it to you. I'm telling you,
yes,
Lord. The Lord heard your cry. I'm telling you, there's going to be some angels, hallelujah, that's coming to your rescue, woman of God. And what you can't do in the natural.
That's right.
I'm telling you, God is getting ready to make up the difference.
Come on.
You need God to make some stuff up here for you. But I'm giving you this prophetic word, watch this now, that he's getting ready to show the years that the kingdom of the locust preach God, the cocoa horn and the caterpillar, God knows the divine restoration that gets your dose
set.
With the enemy, make no bad. There's a turning taking place right now. I dare you shout, things are turning for me. Come on, I know she ain't the only one.
Things are turning!
The prophetic word going for you. You got to know how to sense that word. I dare you to holler, things are turning for me.
Right?
I dare you to holler, you making things crooked straight and things that won't move. I dare you to holler, God is turning. Who is Angela? She's a member here? Lift your hands. Where she is? See, I don't know her. Y'all, lift your hands. Y'all ain't talking back to the preacher. Hallelujah. I'm telling y'all, we're in a prophetic moment. I don't ever heard Angela before in my life. Come on now, that's the Holy Ghost. Watch this now. Lift your hands. See, when we get together and pray, we can stop what the devil want to do. I don't know what she is. I can remember. Lift your hands. I called this young lady to hang out in the church. She brought her son that was bound by a wheelchair.
Wow.
Y'all ain't talking back to me. Lift your hands.
Come on.
We're going to go in for Angela. I don't know what she is, but I'm telling you, the enemy, amen, desires to shift her as we. But I'm telling you, by the hand of God,
yes.
Lift your hands.
Yeah, Lord. Come on.
Lift your hands. You'll be standing in the gap for Angela. God will thank her right now, God. And there's a blessing connected to her.
Touch the Lord. Touch it, Jesus.
This right here is not natural. What she going through ain't natural. But I'm prophesying this. God said he's something out of which to leave.
Right? Come on.
Y'all ain't talking back. Lift your hands in this place. Lift your hands up. You better get me in right now. But I'm telling you, God had a miracle. Yeah, I feel the Holy
come
Ghost.
Come on, come on.
With Angela's name on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. is getting ready to move for the people up under the sound of my voice.
Come on.
God ain't saying that back to me. God said, God, I just lied. I repent. He already moved.
Y'all come on. Y'all come on. He is.
Now, Mr. Charlie, I'm telling y'all, I'm in this place right now. I'm telling y'all by the mercies of God, that God and I are going to move in this place and divine direction. And you better give me the last time I was here, I'm going to say it again. Y'all ain't going to be here too much more. I'm seeing that by the side of my eye. Let me tell you.
Yes, Lord.
And she told me, she said, I don't think I'm going to be able to sing because my leg hurt.
Come on.
I said, don't worry about it. Just meet me in church. Y'all ain't talking back to me. So you got to understand, who believes in signs, wonders, and miracles?
I know.
Now, I don't pray for them. I believe they follow me.
Woo, it's
going to be healed.
Yeah. I'm not praying for signs and the wonders and miracles of faith, faith. I know it's taking place because as I move, they're following me.
Come on, come on!
We all believe. And the Bible says signs, wonders, and miracles of God follow them that believe.
Yeah, believe.
Don't have any believers in this.
Come on, place. I believe.
Speak to her leg and command her leg to go. You better hear what I'm saying. Lift your hands in this place. Lift your hands, lift your hands, lift your hands.
Yes,
Jesus. All of them 19. That's powerful. Watch this. God told me to tell you, you don't want y'all inspired to go to school? What you want to do? Hey, right, what you want to do? Hey, you mean, what you want to do? Huh? Watch this, look at your hands. I seen four people, I might be the fourth one, I don't know. Why is somebody else is here? Come on, listen. God told me to tell you, watch this now. That each of you will not be the employee, you'll be the employer.
Wow.
Hey. I said each of you will not be employees.
Wow, wow.
Lift your hands.
You're going to
be employers.
That's powerful.
Hallelujah.
That's powerful.
God told me to tell you, each of you will be entrepreneurs.
Wow, that's right.
Hallelujah.
Come on now.
You won't work for nobody, people will work for you.
Come on now, say it.
Y'all ain't saying that back to me.
Woo! That's powerful, Pastor.
You want to start your own law firm? God has already done it.
Wow.
You'll have your own HVAC system. SBs ain't going to have nothing on you.
Come on.
Y'all been talking back to
come
you.
Come on, Paul.
Y'all been talking back to you. What do you do for free without being paid for? What's your passion? What's your drive? Music. If you play, get someone wrong, drum me out. Play wrong. Lift your hands. God told me to tell you a gift will make room for you. Lift your hands, I'm telling you. But these are Lord Jesus.
Yes.
I feel the glory of God. Wealth.
Yes.
And riches.
Come on.
Are in your hands.
Come on.
You hear me? I say wealth and riches are in your hands. In the early days. Wealth and riches, lift your hands. God, I thank you right now, God. And we couple these 319 years. Thank you that the enemy will not contaminate the spirits.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. We come against any ungodly contact, Father God. In the name of Jesus. We thank you that through these three millenniums, hallelujah, yes, Lord. That they should marry God in the name of Jesus.
That's right.
That they should have one wife and one husband.
Come on, come on.
In the
yeah Lord. Come on.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I want y'all to know and understand how hard it is for millennials to come to church.
Come on.
This dispensation.
That's true.
Most millennials don't believe in God.
That's right. Atheists.
Most millennials are bound by homosexuality or lesbianism.
Wow.
Y'all talking back to
me. Come on.
And it's hard statistically to get 19, 21, 20-year-olds, 18-year-olds.
That's true.
To come to the house of God.
Amen.
In 2017.
Come on.
You said it's church, amen, etiquette and church growth. We don't have nobody this age in church. The average age for a person in church is 35 to 50 years old.
Wow.
And up.
Come on.
Now they're talking back to the
priest. Wow, 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 wow.
Lift your hands. God, I pray right now. In the name of Jesus. This world has spoken over their lives, God. That you baptize them with the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
And with fire, God.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you right now for they're coming to their identity right now, God. In the name of Jesus, thank you that their feet shall be planted.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In the name of Jesus, Lord, we magnify you, glorify you. In Jesus' name. Come on, put your hands together.
Come on.
Are you hearing? How old are you? How old are you? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I thought she was 13. 13.
Lift your
hands. Lord. If this ain't a little preacher,
come on now.
Lift your hands. Can I tell you something? You can't be around this way.
Oh, my.
Lift your hands.
Come on now.
You've been made in the image of God. Let me tell you something. Can't no enemy of boy tell you anything.
That's right.
You so protected by God.
Yeah.
It ain't nothing wrong with you. Can I tell you that?
Yeah.
Ain't nothing wrong with you. You can't fit in because you don't supposed to fit. Lift your hand. Lift your hand. And the reason you can't fit in, because God has his hand over your life.
That's right.
You can't do nothing to other little girls.
Mm.
Do. And don't worry about popularity.
That's true.
God ain't talking about that. They laugh at you now. They gonna celebrate you later.
Wow.
I see a congregation of righteous. You better give me. I see God using you in the political arena.
Come on.
I see you changing governmental systems. Lift your hands in this place. I'm telling you. See, we need the prophetic voice to divinely direct our children. What's the matter? So what's the matter? Tomorrow. What's the latest? Lift your hands. God is going to use you in the political arena. For most of us, the hand, the fight, and the power of God is upon your life.
That's right.
And God got a young man just for you.
Woo. Come on.
You hear me? There are angels literally that fight you, that follow you all around.
My God.
And when you want to go to the left or go to the right, I'm telling you, there are literally angels that have a spot right there when you can't do what you want to do.
My Lord, my Lord.
If I be a prophet of God, if you ain't no preacher, I ain't never seen one. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. God, thank you. Thank you that the fire and the power of God is upon you. Thank you that you baptized us. That you baptize on the front of the Holy Ghost and the Father.
Yes.
Thank you that every gift come up out of her in the name of Jesus. I speak activation right now that when she opened her mouth, God, it's your name.
Yeah.
Oh God, I feel it. I thank you right now, God, that Africa is calling my name, God. Yes, Lord. I thank you right now, God, that deep and sure in her voice, God. Thank you right now, God, that you activate and every gift stirred up down on the inside of God shall come out and come into fruition in this season, God, in the name of Jesus. I prophetically declare over her life, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you right now, in Jesus' name. Come on, put your hands together.